Hi, everybody. Okay, so what are we going to do tonight? Let me tell you who I am. I'm a brand ambassador for Dixie Belle Paint Company, one of the brand ambassadors. I am coming to you live from my shop, which is San Antonio, Texas. Tracey's Fancy is where I'm coming to you from, and we are working on a vanity tonight. If you have any questions about Dixie Belle paint products, let me know. Tonight we are mostly going to use just paints, and I'm going to talk to you a little tiny bit about prep, and then talk to y'all about choosing paint colors or a design, because that seems to be where a lot of people struggle. If you follow me on my page, which is Tracey's Fancy on both Instagram and Facebook, I put a post up today talking about prep work and what stops you from going forward with your DIY project. Painting is so easy, the colors are so beautiful, it's so much fun, it's so enjoyable. So what is it that slows you down or keeps you from the process? And a lot of people said that it has to do with there's too much prep work involved, and they don't want to do the fixing or the repairs and the sanding and all that sort of stuff. So my answer to that is I just have gotten to where I buy pieces that I don't have to do a lot of repair on. I upped my budget. I increased my budget, basically. Time is money, and I don't have a lot of time to put into the prep work. So if I'm doing a custom order for a client, I make sure that I have them send me pictures of it first and really get a good look at what condition it's in. And then when it gets to me, I give it a really good look over. If it's going to require too much work, I have to either pass on it or I raise my price. If I'm looking for a piece to do, like this one for content, and I picked this up as I thrifted live with you guys on World of Chalk Paint and the private group. Are y'all a member of that group, World of Chalk Paint?
Wow, okay. Mama might have to get this. Today might be the day. Yeah, that's pretty good. It's
already good. I found this live with y'all and y'all talked me into buying it. So I bought it. It's more than I usually spend. And I didn't think it needed any work, but when I got it home, it did. It needed to be sanded badly. Even though Dixie Belle paint is, no prep involved, sometimes you do have to prep. There's a lot of variables that come into play. So anyway, I did. I sanded this piece down. After I sanded, not all the way, not completely, but what I do want to talk to y'all about is, do y'all see these spots? So this piece was sanded, not because the paint was peeling. The paint was actually very, very intact, but it had, okay, so let's talk about prep. I sanded it down, not all the way, but in some areas, because it's curvy, I did kind of break through the veneer a little bit, not all the way down to raw wood, but in a couple places I did. So especially up on the top. So what I want to talk to you about is if you are sanding a piece and you've sanded it down and you went just a little too far through the thin veneer and you can actually see some of the veneer come through underneath, you need to seal that before you paint it. It will accept the paint differently than the painted surface. So if these were a little bit darker, this I wasn't worried so much about, but if this had broke through, can y'all see that good enough? If that had broken through and was darker, like maybe the corner of this drawer here, it depends on what paint color you're using, but it can happen even with dark paint colors. So if you're using like peacock, which is like a beautiful vibrant blue, sometimes where your peacock is on your piece in those spots, if you've pulled through some of the broken through the veneer, it'll accept that peacock color differently, and so it dries differently. So if that happens, it's an easy fix. All you have to do, and I did it today, I just used one of our application pads, and I used satin top coat, and you just seal it. So I just poured this onto my pad, and anywhere that I had those areas, I just ran a satin top coat over the top of it. It's an easy fix. You're just sealing it. You're just sealing that surface there. Anyway, that's that. So now it's ready to go. Before I did that, I sanded it, and then I cleaned it with White Lightning, which is Dixie Belle's really good cleaner, and then I put a little top coat all over it, and now I'm going to get started. Now, the top of it, guys, the top surface was thick with brush strokes. So if you'll look for that 1 minute video on my Instagram or my Facebook, I posted it about an hour ago prepping y'all for tonight. It was the way I was going to lead y'all over here to come watch tonight. I put that video up so that you could see how terrible the surface of this was all over. I showed you the difference between the drawers and the top, the unsanded versus the sanded. It was so thick with brush strokes. Now, I'm a brush painter. I'm not a sprayer. I don't spray my Dixie Belle. I paint my Dixie Belle with a brush. And I just don't enjoy spraying that much, so I don't do it. I think it's a beautiful finish, but I'm a brush painter, so I'm not opposed to brush strokes at all. But guys, these were bad. I mean, they're probably some of the worst brush strokes I've ever seen. Ever. So much so that I decided to do a video about it to let y'all know what I was prepping for. Did I have to sand the piece? No. The only reason I sanded it was because it had deep, deep, deep brush strokes that were in the top coat. There's no way that you can hide those. So if you see a piece that's thick with brush strokes, if they're that bad, I want you to know when you put your paint on top of it, they're only gonna settle into those brush strokes. It's not going to hide them. People are like, oh, I thought it would fill in that wood grain. I thought my paint would just fill that in, or I thought it would fill in those brush strokes. No, it just settles into the brush strokes. So if you want your finish to be smooth, you have to smooth your substrate. You have to smooth the surface that you're gonna be painting if you want a smooth finish. Now, remember the piece we did last week, you guys? We worked on it for 2 weeks, the table with the sea spray, right? And we were adding texture to our paint. If I had wanted this to be an old world look, I could have added sea spray to my paint, left all the brush strokes, they would have been fine because we would have covered them up with texture additive in our paint. Okay, so that's that. We are prepped, we're ready to go. So now I wanna talk about color. So I'm gonna show y'all what I've decided for this piece, I think, at least to get me started. And I'm gonna start with Antebellum Blue and Mermaid Tail. And I can't decide if I'm gonna use Mint Julep as well, and then I want y'all to see my other option, or if I'm gonna go with Limeade, okay? And we'll talk about why, what the difference is between those two, and how I came up with this. If you really are struggling, if you're not making a piece for a specific room, you just have some free time, and you've got a piece in your garage or in your house, and you just wanna paint it, and you can't decide what color you wanna use, if you have no specific piece of inspiration, what are you drawn to? What colors are you usually drawn to? Go look in your closet. I always say that. Go look in your closet and see what you have the most of in your closet. Those are probably the colors that you're drawn to more often than not. So I always suggest that. Take pictures of things when you're out walking around or when you're shopping or when you are taking a walk in the woods and you see the sunlight hit the fern just right or the moss in the tree and you're like, oh my gosh, that's gorgeous. Capture that moment. Take a picture of it with your phone and then come home and match your Dixie Belle paint colors to it. And that you're using something in nature as your inspiration. And the way the sun hits colors and changes the colors, you can take that photo, that still shot, and pull all those little colors out and match it to color all the gazillion colors that Dixie Belle offers. So that's just a way to get started. Another thing is just get a base coat on it. If it's brown wood, sometimes just putting gray boss on it will help you get started. It sort of takes away the brown and it helps you to start being able to see a little bit more. So instead of pulling up cobalt blue, it's a little bold, I decided to go with Antebellum Blue, which is gorgeous. Okay, so here's my Mermaid Tail, right? Now watch what happens. I'm gonna put one on the top and one, well actually, this is Limeade. I love Limeade, but this is very funky and very bold, right? So this would be our deeper color. This would be where we'd get our shadows. This is our middle color, which is like your main tone color. And then this would be our lighter color, which is where I would pull in highlights, like on the curved spaces or the curved areas of the drawers or the outer curve of the leg, as if we're faking that light is being captured on the piece. That's where you want to put your lighter colors. So this is this, but this kind of gives a funky vibe, right? Now, if I take it and I slide off the Limeade and I slide on instead Mint Julep, now we've gone a little bit elegant. Now we've gone fun and playful with color, but we've gone a little more adult, right? It's a little more mainstream, if you will, for color, versus if we knock that off and we put, literally knock it off, and we put the Limeade on, we've gone a little funky. So we may do tonight one leg in each and just see if we can tell a difference. Now, I'm not going to do the whole piece in that. I think I'm only going to do like the legs and the body in that. The drawer fronts, I think, and the sides, I think I'm going to pull in some pinks. So I am thinking of using Muscadine Wine and Plum Crazy, Muscadine Wine, Plum Crazy, and Tea Rose. So I think I'm going to do a set of pinks as well. Now, when I pulled the pinks out today, I had no other inspiration other than what was in my brain. So I'm just giving y'all a little warning. I think that's where I'm starting. I'm not sure. I don't have to stick to it. I do not have to stick to it. I just get started. Take action. Okay, but when I brought out all these colors, it made me think of this. Now, I was not going to use extra product on this piece. I wanted this piece to be all paint. But then when I pulled these papers out, I was like, oh, that's like every single color that is in, that is every single color that is in my paint, in my hand. So I'm going to start with, usually when you work with three variations of one color, usually I start with my middle color. Okay, because this is the one I'm going to shadow with. This is the one I'm going to highlight with. So I usually start with my middle color. Okay, I on purpose brought three brushes to the table today. I've arrived with three brushes on purpose, actually four, to show you that all brushes work. All brushes work. Now, everyone will inevitably find their favorite brush. My favorite brush is this one right here, which is the flat medium. I love this brush. This is the flat medium. This is the flat small. This is the difference between the two. Flat small, flat medium, flat small, flat medium, flat small. It's a little too small for me. Flat medium is perfect for my child size hands. I'm a larger woman with baby hands. I'm also going to be using an oval small, which is just meaning it's oval instead of flat in its shape, just like that. These are the synthetic brushes that are an investment in your craft. They're an investment in your business. They're amazing brushes. They last forever. And then the premium chip brush. This is one of the Dixie Belle premium chip brushes. So it's my fourth brush that I've got out here. So I brought four brushes, and then I have my water bottle with me. And you don't have to have your water bottle. I just want to be able to spritz my paint in case my paint's a little bit thick. I'm not going to be, we'll be blending here in just a minute, okay? I just want to get y'all situated so everybody can see. There we go. All right, so we're going to work on this leg right here. Everybody can see this leg. I've got it on casters down here so I can paint it all the way to the bottom, and these allow me to roll it. You can just get these on Amazon or at your local hardware store. They're called furniture dollies. So normally I just wet my brush a little bit, just like this. Okay, it's hot as blue blazes out here, guys, so this paint dries fast, really, really fast. I'm gonna go ahead and just slide over to the other leg and move y'all with me so that y'all can see. There we go. We'll get this leg done, even though I know I didn't go around that leg. Always so graceful on the floor down here. We'll get this leg covered. Okay, do y'all see this little lip part underneath here? You wanna go ahead and, on the French Provincial pieces, this curve, you wanna make sure you paint underneath here because that curve can be seen from the side. All right, let's go over here. Okay, so that's done. So what I do now is I take my paint like this and my brush and I just set it like that. That means this brush is for this color and I've got it set aside here. So now I'm gonna move this back down. Let's roll it back down. And we are gonna blend out this leg. Let me turn. So now let's go ahead and open the Antebellum Blue. And I'm gonna use, let's use the flat small brush for that one. Gorgeous color. You wanna see the lid? Okay, so again, I'm gonna wet my brush and I'm going to do kind of like an ombre, but it'll be a blend. So I want it to be dark at the bottom. So I'm gonna go ahead and put my blue right on top of my mermaid tail. It hasn't had really long enough to completely dry. It might activate a little bit with my water, but I think we're good. This is gonna be a very rough view. I'm not gonna worry about painting the back side of the leg. I just want y'all to be able to see. We'll just blend out one leg for you here. So you wanna get enough on there. Do about like that. How's that? Good? Now, same thing, I'm gonna take my brush, I'm gonna set it aside. So now each brush belongs to each paint color. All right, so now I'm gonna open up, I'm just still very torn. But I'm not gonna use Limeade right now. I think I am gonna use Mint Julep. See, I have to think about it. I think I am gonna use Mint Julep. I'm just gonna put some right on this outer curve for the time being, just for right now. I'm not quite sure how I wanna do that, but I'm gonna use my oval small. Just put a touch of it right here. Oh, I forgot to show y'all. This is Mint Julep. It's not really like it's mint, but it's not like, you know, I judge mint by mint chocolate chip ice cream. How about y'all? And it's not the color of mint chocolate chip ice cream, but it is mint for sure. It's just not the color of chocolate chip. All right, when I just want a little bit, I just want to come in and just kind of hit it up on this leg like this. That's all I'm going to do. Just kind of pounce that on. Okay. So I'm probably gonna put some right here too. So I'll go ahead and put some on here. Anywhere there's a curve like this. Yeah, that's where it's gonna be. Pretty rough looking, right? So now I'm gonna put that just like that. All right, let's buff out some of these colors a little bit. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back and I wanna blend this line out that's right here, this really rough line. I'm gonna go back and get this color, which is my base color. I'm gonna pick it up, pick my brush up, and I'm just gonna re-wet that color right here. Just gonna put a little bit right above that line, right where they meet, just like that. Just some fresh right above that line. Now I'm gonna pick up my blue brush, and it's still pretty wet, but I'm gonna put some right below that line, okay? And then I just wanna kinda bring them together. And you can do that by either bringing your brush up into that. You're just gonna soften this line out. And then you wanna take your cloth that you got here, because you got mermaid tail on there. You wanna take that off and get back down here into the bottom again. Keep bringing that up. And we're gonna go up to the top and bring our mermaid tail back down in just a sec. So now I'm gonna take my mermaid tail brush and I'm gonna bring some of that down just like this. Sometimes you have to stop what you're doing, kind of step away from it if your colors start to get a little muddy. My white's coming through a little bit because I didn't have that. That didn't really have time to dry, but it looks okay. It's blended out. Now I'm going to go up in here. I'm going to come around this mint. Now you can do like a pounce blend if you want. It's a lot easier if you're a beginner. So think about it like when you're putting makeup on and you're blending out your eyeshadow. It's kind of like that. So do you see how that's starting to look like a highlighted area? We're going to add a little more blue up here so it stands out a little bit more. Not blue, but the mermaid tail. Do you see that? Now I'm going to pick my chip brush up again and just kind of buff that out. You see that? How that's starting to look highlighted? I think I'm pretty good with that until it dries. And then I'll come back for the third coat, which will be, so this was my second coat. So we did the first base coat, and then we've done our first blend coat, which is right now. Got a little bristle in there. And I'll let that dry, and then I'll come back and I'll do what's like your finishing coat. So ignore this, but you see how that looks deep, and then it comes up, and then it's highlighted right here. And so I'll probably bring all of the colors up just like this. I'll bring these up, and I'll highlight right here again with that. With the mint, I like the mint a lot. Isn't it funny how the mint actually looks limeade? I'll let that dry and then I'll come back in and I'll fine tune it and add a little bit more fresh color and spritz it with some water and kind of fine tune it a little bit. So the mint does look good, doesn't it? It looks really good. So see, this is what it looked like a second ago, and then now this is what it looks like as you work it in. Anyway, guys, I think that's it. I'm gonna move on away from here. Thanks y'all so much for being such a wonderful audience tonight. I really appreciate it. I thank y'all for joining me. Y'all have a wonderful night, and we'll see y'all next week. Y'all take care. Bye-bye.